feel identified with that description of life without Jesus. If you have no Christ in your life, this is the way you're going to live your life. If you have no Jesus in your life, you are going to be an adulterer and a fornicator. Your language is going to be unclean and foul. Your life is going to be full of lewdness, idolatry, sorcery, hatred, contentious. You're going to be constantly fighting, and you're going to have a fight at home with your wife, with your kids, at work, with your friends. Friends, the Bible says that life without Jesus is horrible. But look at what life with Jesus is like. Now, let me show you the beauty of this. Is that what I'm looking for? Yes, the next one. But the fruit of the Spirit. When Jesus comes through the Spirit to live into your life, you are going to be like a tree that produces fruits. Remember the coconut? In the coconut was found a tree, the leaves, and eventually the fruits. You are inside Jesus Christ. Jesus is that coconut. You are inside Christ. And as you live your life in Jesus, you are going to produce fruits, friends. And notice the fruits. The fruits are as following. Love. You are going to love everyone around you, whether they are Chinese, South Americans, Middle Eastern. Doesn't matter what religion they have, what way they think, what political affiliation they have, what football club they like, whether they like Holden or Ford, you will love everyone. Even more, friends, the Bible says that you will even begin to love those who have damaged you, those who have wronged you. Your enemies will be now loved by you. That is the first sign that Jesus has come into your heart. If you were horrible at home and you beat your children and your wife and you gave them the life of a dog, let me tell you a story. There were two people arguing where was heaven. One was saying, heaven is that direction. The other one was saying, no, heaven is that direction. And they argued there for about half an hour, and suddenly there was a little boy coming with a ball. And he heard them arguing and says, what are you arguing about? Where is heaven? Where do you think is heaven? And he said, heaven is that direction. Ah, you're crazy, little boy. Why you say that heaven is that direction? Because my dad was converted. Before, he used to beat my mom. He used to beat us all. He never bought clothes or shoes. We were hungry. And when he gave his life to Jesus, now he loves my mom. He loves us. And there is heaven because Jesus is in our home. And dear friends, how true that is. The home that accepts Jesus, the life that takes Christ, is the life that becomes a little heaven here on earth, and that life will begin to love everyone around. Everyone around. And then, friends, not only love will fill your life, but when Jesus comes into your heart, sadness will give way, and now joy will fill your life. Doesn't matter what happens in life, there will be a deep joy in your heart that will control everything you do. And friends, there will be peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such, Paul says, there is no law. And dear friends, and those who are in Christ have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. I don't know whether you have heard the story of George Mueller. George Mueller was the son of a rich merchant who lived in Germany or Austria. He grew up in this home where there was everything. His mother died at an early age. But George Mueller was so selfish that when his mother was in hospital dying, he didn't even care to go and visit his mother. He just kept partying and going from pub to pub. George was a selfish, a horrible human being. He loved stealing. He loved making people's life miserable. One day he went to church. A friend invited him to go to church. And you know what happened? At church, he met Jesus for the first time in his life. And the life of George was transformed. So much so, friends, that George gave his life to the Lord and began to work for others. And George stands as one of those people who have loved to the extent that maybe no other or little others have loved. George developed a system of orphanages in the city where he lived, and he adopted in his lifetime, 10,000 children. How many? 10,000 children. At the end of his life, George could say that the Lord had done something beautiful of his life. Friends, do you want Jesus to do something beautiful of your life? And I believe that most of you have accepted Christ while coming to these meetings. If you have, from tonight onwards, I want you to take by faith the fact that you are precious in God's eyes. You are not worthless, friends. You are valued by God everything. You are precious in God's eyes. Take away, surrender to Jesus the thought that you are worth nothing. Give him your negativeness. Give him the pain of your heart. Give him yourself to the Lord, and the Lord will give you love, peace, and joy. What do you think of the things that we have said? I'd like to invite Kim to come and sing. And tonight I'm not going to ask you to stand up. I'm going to ask you to listen to the song. And I'm going to ask you to make a decision there and deep in your heart. I'm going to ask you to make the decision that from now on you are going to live as a child of God. That you are going to live your life with Jesus. And that you are going to consider yourself the most precious possession God has in his hands. Listen to the song.
In the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, give me Jesus, give me Jesus.
Precious to know that we have a God that values us with such a high price, isn't it? Isn't that beautiful, friends? Aren't you happy to have a God that looks at you and says, you are my child. I love you. You are precious to me. And dear friends, no one can take that out of you. You may be alone, rejected by human beings. You may be poor.